Cor and Jenny left their friends and family behind on the docks of the Rotterdam harbour on Friday, November 21st, 1958. With their nine-month-old daughter Erika in their arms, they stood on the deck of the ship, waving the Dutch shores farewell. The journey on the Statendam would take 8 days, making stops at Le Havre, France, and Southampton, England, with New York City as the final destination. It was a luxurious trip, at least in their opinion. 2 hot meals a day, lots of dessert options, and at least 25 items on the breakfast menu. You only had to open your mouth and the waiters, mainly young German boys, came running to provide you with anything you might wish for. Their cabin had a bathtub, and Jenny immediately took advantage of this luxury on their first night. It was a marvelous experience, she wrote to her parents and sister in her first letter. When they were crossing the English Channel, it seemed very narrow because at night they could see the lights from the shores of England on one side and those of France and Belgium on the other. This made land appear closer than it actually was. Traveling by ship didn't exactly go as smooth as Jenny had hoped for. It was very noisy because of the air conditioning. The further along they sailed, the more noise the ship began to make, creaking and squeaking from all sides. Being a little seasick made Jenny lose her appetite for a while. A couple of days into the journey, they even went through quite a storm. Everything that wasn't fastened, chairs, suitcases, and the entire content of the breakfast table, came tumbling down. The storm caused a delay of 1 day, and they arrived in New York on the 30th of November, 1958.